Talk about this character in the North of Wings.
Yeah, she's called Bet Sykes. She is an invented character, which is a real relief to me. And she is one of the villains in the show. I think for me and my own personal agenda, and also which was what I was really happy about with the writing, is that my agenda was to create a female villain for 2019. Which basically means that there's a lot more to fear about her than your desire for her, because women have a lot more going for them than their sexuality. And I feel like it's updated and it's important. You know, she is, like all good villains, she plays with your own feelings, because she's not just one-dimensionally evil, because in reality nobody really is. Some of the most horrific people in history were nice to the people we worked for, and I'm sure they saw things in them that we like made them question, you know, their thoughts and feelings about them. And I think I played with that when I was working on this character. Like, she's a human being and she longs for human connection and touch, and she longs for acknowledgement, and I think she feels misunderstood and often undervalued. And I think there's a lot of parallels between her and Alfred Pennyworth, because in America you have a system where you're raised to believe that you can achieve and be anything you want regardless of what financial circumstance you were born into. But in England we still to this day have terrible issues about class divide, and I think that's an interesting theme when you're dealing with talking about Britain in an era like the 60s. But Alfred and Bet were both born into working class background, and the inevitability of that is that you will always be serving somebody else who has more than you, and even if you need to do better than that, the doors will close on you. So I think that when we play or not, there are moments in the series where Alfred and Bet come together that are really important, because I think they kind of know, there's like an understanding, like who's to say who's the good guy, who's to say who's the bad guy. And sometimes we get confused, our characters do, about why we're both fighting for the same thing, because our desires and our culture is probably very similar. And I think that's interesting, and I think when we're looking at it from a social political perspective, there are a lot of parallels between like the Western world, this sort of internal civil war that's going on between left and right, that's going on in Britain and in America, and this is happening in our show also. So yeah, everyone believes their cause to be the right cause and the just cause and the one for the greater good, but the reality is if you're left you think the right's evil, and if you're right you think the left's evil. So that's kind of a lot of what happens in this show.
And last question.
This is a kind of a period piece, so what's it like to kind of live in almost 60s. Like an alternate 60s?
To be honest, for me, coming from the music background that I come from, and also the fact that all through my early 20s I was obsessed by vintage, like the way I dress every day, it wasn't really that much different from my actual life. I think it was more of a sort of a change for them guys, but I've always valued and enjoyed 50s and 60s design and haven't really moved on from it. So I was just very at home. In fact, it was just difficult not to steal the props.